said be back in a minute. Bought a boat and I sailed off in it. Don't think anybody's gonna miss me anyway. Mind on a permanent vacation. The ocean is my only medication. Wishing my condition ain't ever gonna go away. Cause now I'm knee deep in the water somewhere. Got the blue sky breeze blowing through my hair. Only worry in the world is the tide gonna reach my ship.
We're heading up this vista, and we start talking about music and songwriting and our careers and his life and my life and death. And he goes, you know, Eric, he said, guys like us, we don't really die. He said, because the songs live forever. And this one will.
Smoked a bowl with Jimmy on the roof of the Vatican. Remember, Jimmy? This is a good evening, isn't it? Wow. Don't you all feel really good? That's Jimmy. Right? That's Jimmy. Even now, Jimmy has the ability to, like Tinkerbell, spread happiness all over. You know, I love what Harrison said about Jimmy Buffett, and I don't know if he used this word, but the word generous always comes to me when I think of Jimmy Buffett. He was such a generous man, generous of heart, generous of spirit. He loved people, and that's why we love him, because we could feel that. You know, even through his music, you could feel that. And so, you know, just remember that about the Vatican roof and everything. I have the honor right now to bring on the stage a woman that I admire from the bottom of my heart, one of the great American singers, who never ceases to surprise us with her style and range. It's so vast. Please welcome Brandi Carlile.
I wanna go back to the island where the shrimp boats are tied up to the piling. Give me oysters and beer for dinner every day of the year, and I'll be fine. Heading up to San Francisco for the Labor Day weekend show. I got my hush puppies on. I guess I never was meant for glitter, rock and roll. Honey, I didn't know that I'd be missing your soul. But come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown LA haze, and I just want you back by my side.
Trying to make my carnivorous habit, and you get 70 days losing weight without speed. Sunflower seeds, drinking lots of characters, and so
whenever we talk about them, we breathe more life into those memories and they become even bigger, right? And I have so many memories of Jimmy and Jane and the kids and my kids, all of us together, so many awesome memories. And I was thinking today about one that stuck out. Years ago, I was down, Jane Fonda was talking about Jimmy's generosity. Jimmy and Jane have been so good to me over the years, and I was staying with them down in the Caribbean. And I woke up one morning and Jimmy was getting ready to go somewhere. And if you knew Jimmy, you knew that he was either coming from somewhere or going somewhere, often at the same time. And I said, Jimmy, where are you going? And he said, I gotta go get certified for the takeoff and landing at the St. Barts Airport. Now, the St. Barts Airport is death-defying. It's like a controlled crash, and it's scary. And he said, I gotta go, and I gotta get certified. I gotta go do a bunch of takeoff and landings, like 30 of them. And he said, you wanna go? And I said, yeah, of course I wanna go. And he said, great, I'll just go get my stuff. And he left the room. Jane turned to me and she said, dude, Jimmy has been in like 3 plane crashes.
And he did that show with a broken leg. Big smile you ever saw. The next time I got to be on stage with him was probably 50 years later, and I opened for him in a stadium, a football stadium in Detroit. This is a song that Jimmy wrote for a friend of his who had been in the Spanish Civil War and had survived that and went on to go live in Europe, only to lose his family in World War II. Now, you knew this guy in Chicago, but in the last chapter of the song, and he gave him a last chapter in his life of a life in the Caribbean, which is what he would want for himself, what he would want for any of us, too. You know what? The reason I don't have any level in my earphones is they're not in my ears. You know? He went to Paris looking for answers to questions that bothered him so. He was impressive, young and aggressive, saving the world on his own. The warm summer breezes, the French wines and cheeses, but his ambition that day. The summers and winters scattered like splinters, 4 or 5 years away.
About an even more specific situation that none of us are ever going to be in. But he took that and he wrote a song that I believe applies to everybody in the Hollywood Bowl this evening. This is Bubbles Up. When this world starts reeling from that pressure drop feeling, we're just treading water these days. There's a way to feel better, be well set to weather the storm till the sun shines again. When your compass is spinning and you're lost on the way, like a leaf in the wind, friend, hear me when I say, bubbles up, they will point you toward home. No matter how deep and how far you roam, they will show you the surface, the plot and the purpose. So when the journey is long, just know that you are loved, and there is light up above, and joy, there's always enough.
I breeze through. It's 2 in the morning and the party's still jumping because my mama ain't home. I got bitches in the living room getting it on and they ain't leaving till 6 in the morning. So what you wanna do? Shit, I got a pocket full of rubbers and my homeboys do too. So turn off the lights and close the doors. But what? Yeah. So we gon' smoke an ounce to this. Cheese up, hose down while you motherfuckers bounce to this. We smoking.
Sipping on gin and juice.
Lay back on the morning. What everybody saying, bro?
Rolling down the street, we smoking in go. Sipping on gin and juice.
Lay back. And now that I've got me some Seagram's gin, everybody.
I mean, it's, God, it's incredible they'd be here. It's safe to say, judging by tonight, that I think Jimmy probably had more friends and more fans than anyone I know. And I'm proud to say I was a friend of his. The guy always had a twinkle in his eye. He always had a smile on his face. He always seemed to be having such a damn fucking good time. He'd come up to me and he'd say, "Look, John, I just spoke to my Uncle Warren." I don't know about you guys, but he got me convinced they were related. Because they were both so damn smart. So I'm hoping they're gonna give me some investment advice. But actually, Jimmy would end up saying, because he came to a couple of my matches, he'd say, "Relax, man, you're too fucking wound up."
What we call the knee of the Jedi and ask advice of Jimmy. Life's lessons were learned with Jimmy. Last summer, we sat at a picnic table at his house and he played me the mixes, Bubbles Up, and My Gummy Just Kicked In, and his whole new record. And I had the honor, privilege, and pleasure of calling him my friend for 20 years. And as he sat at that picnic table just last summer, He looked at me with that big shit-eating grin, and he says, I'm going back. We're going back. Let's get out there and rock these people again. I'm going to be back. I'm going to promote this record. He inspired the beautiful things in life. That there's an old saying about seizing the day. Jimmy taught me to embrace the day, to enjoy the moments, to enjoy your family, to enjoy your friends. And it's been my honor and privilege to be here with you tonight and with the Coral Reefer Band. And Miss Jane, I love you. Thank you all. Have a great rest of your evening.
I know I got way too stoned on Jimmy's gummies backstage. Because I swear to God, I thought I just saw Snoop Dogg sing Gin and Juice with a Coral Reefer Band. We love Jimmy and Jane, and they're the most generous, wonderful people ever. I remember once we were in St. Bart's, and Jimmy said, do you want to fly with me? I have to practice landing at the airport 30 times. And I said, yeah.
Yeah.
And it was fine. He did a good job. And the moral of the story is Will Arnett is a pussy.
It is true. I got hired by Jimmy Buffett. He didn't know me from Adam in 1989 with a couple of, actually three of the Coral Reefers who are from St. Louis, some very, very dear friends. I was absolutely a nobody, and I got to sing backup on Off to See the Lizard with Timothy B. Schmidt. But I have to preface the story by saying I came from St. Louis, I flew to Miami, I got on a small commuter jet. We had a bomb scare. They flew us in 100 yards above the water. They foam landed us, and then the FBI showed up. And then forevermore, Jimmy would say, this girl knows how to show up to a party. So with that in mind, and actually I will tell you, he is for me the most beautiful illustration of what it means to be alive and awake and absolutely present in every moment. And Janie, I love you. I'm so happy to be a part of this. So how many of you guys are land sharks? Are you here with me? I know you're parrot heads, but are you land sharks? All right, I need to see some fins. I know we're in Hollywood, but I need to see some fins out here. Get my fins up, all right? All right, here's the thing. I know Jimmy is probably laughing his ass off right now with a big fat joint and a margarita. And he's watching y'all, so let's see some exercise. Let's hit it, guys.
Time he was ever coming over to my house, I tried to explain to him where the studio was. I was hanging out in the studio and he was gonna come. I heard the car show up, I heard the door shut and everything, but the door didn't open, and I figured, okay, he missed the studio door. So I go walking over to my house, and he had gone in there, and my friend was over there watching my kids. My kids are real little, they're taking a nap or something. And I told my friend Crystal, I said, hey, the toilet's clogged and there's a plumber coming. And so anyways, you can already see where it's going. And so by the time I see him already walking the house, I missed my chance, so I follow him in, and she takes him right into the bathroom, and she points Jimmy to where the toilet was. She's like, it's this one right here. And as I walk in the house, I hear Jimmy, he's like looking at my toilet, and he's like, well, I didn't bring my tools today, but I could come back tomorrow and I could check it out. Anyways, he was like one of my dad's friends. He was just a normal old guy, and we miss him. Love you, Jimmy. is this song. This is one of the first, this is probably the reason I kept playing music, is I learned how to play this song when I was 14 years old, called A Pirate Looks at 40. Yes, I am a pirate. Whoa. I jumped ahead. They even got the teleprompter. Sorry, I was hanging out with Snoop Dogg backstage.
Mother Ocean, I have heard your call. I wanted to sail upon your water. Since I was 3 feet tall, you've seen it all. You've seen it all. Watch the men who rode you switch from sails to steam. And in your bed, hold the treasure if you have ever seen. Most of them a dream. Yeah, most of them a dream.
Hell, where do we go? Hell, when the rains came. Down in a hollow. Playing a new game. Back down running, yeah. Skipping and a jumping. Been a lovely crew.
showed up, and Jimmy, of course, was there, and Hunter Thompson, and Glenn Frey, and Don Henley, and Jack Nicholson. And, you know, just a casual dinner, Angelica Houston. And my sister, Miss Jane Buffett, was also there. And Jimmy was cooking, and he made some of the most delicious duck I've ever had. The flavors were so strong, they were able to break through the insane amount of cocaine that we had done. Aspirin in the 80s, or 90s, or... Jimmy was a great host, but he was an even better friend. He always made sure that everyone was having the best possible time. He lit up the room with his stories, some of them fact and most of them fiction. And he turned those stories into best-selling books.
Yeah.
Looking out on this audience tonight, I can see the impact he and his music have had on so many people. He's an inspiration, right? I mean, come on. Like, look at that. A man who made his dreams come true. One of Jimmy's many dreams to come true was sharing the stage and studio with an idol. And our next performer. It's my pleasure to bring out a dear friend of Jimmy's. Please welcome Sir Paul McCartney.
Thank you.
Yes.
Good evening. Hollywood fucking bowl. Come on.
Oh, man.
Yeah!
So, I had the great pleasure of knowing Jimmy. And like everyone else on the bill tonight has said, this is one great man. He was generous. He was funny. He'd done just about everything in his life. And like I say, he was so generous. I was on holiday with him and I forgot to bring my guitar. So he had his own guitar strung left-handed for me. Yeah. So, and then the next time I saw him, he'd had one custom made left-handed for me. So, I love Jimmy, and
love you, Paul.
Love you too. So, just in the last week of his life, I was invited up to his house by Janie. And by the way, this wouldn't have happened tonight. Let's hear it for Janie.
In times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. Let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. When the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be. Oh, let it be.
Sponge cake, watching the sun bake.